Assalamu alaikum viewers, welcome to my channel Genome Wide Study. If you are new on my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon so you will get the notification of all the new videos. This is the video of part 2 of our series that multiple species Synteny analysis. In part 1, we have completed the one step MCScan process and the text merge for MCScanX process and generated the required files for visualization of conserved syntenic region among different species with multiple Synteny plot. The link of part 1 you can find in the description or at the end screen. So how to visualize? By using that three files to Synteny analysis among multiple species of our studied genes. Let's start. So these are the three files that the chromosome, gene link and GFF files. These are the merged files that we have generated in the part 1, and this is the new file that it is the gene list file. These are the list of my organism genes, that my family genes, that HSP70 genes, and I want to check the collinearity or syntenic region of HSP70 gene family from Solanum lacopersicum to Arabidopsis, thaliana, oryza, sativa and GMAX, and this is the gene list. But take care in naming these transcript IDs, so you need to check carefully in GFF file or gene link file that how their names were given. So you will arrange these transcript name accordingly. So we can check it, like I want to check in GFF file or a gene link file. So I need to open it, open in notepad. So here you can see that my gene family name, the transcript name, and here the transcript name is same, like it has the 4ITG dot, so after the transcript name and this version name have. So your name, your gene family name must be according to this. If for example your transcript ID didn't have these dot 1 dot ITAG 2 dot 4, only your transcript ID have this name. So you must add in front of that this version. So make it similar. This name must be similar to gene link generated file name. So after making similar, so now we go to open the TBTool, go to graphics, comparative genomics and multiple Synteny plot. So here we can, this is the set chromosome layout info. So here we, this is the chromosome file, merge file, cross, and gene, this is the set gene position info GFF file that we have got from the merge files, and here is the gene link file info. So first we check it, start, press. So here we are. So here you see that the name of that organism is much more, so we need to delete these. And here the chromosome name of cellular lacopersicum is also big, so we need to arrange them. And here these are a lot of scaffold in the glycine max, so we need to delete these scaffold. So we will do some editing in these files. So how to do? Let's start. So first we open this chromosome file and we only keep the name S lacopersicum, or here you can, if you add the dot, so it's okay, and delete this other up to FA, but keep these two dot, delete it, A dot thaliana, and delete these up to FA, and here again solanum lacopersicum, and delete up to FA, oryza sativa, and delete other up to FA. Gmax up to FA, select and delete it. Now the chromosome of Solanum lacopersicum is also me, so we need, I want to delete that SL2.50, so select it, copy, now go to edit, replace, find what, so here you can paste, keep the cursor, replace with, and here you can replace all. So in Solanum lacopersicum the name that SL50 is deleted from that, so we only get this chromosome name, and we also need to delete that scaffold from glycine max, so we will delete the scaffold, all that scaffold, we only want to keep the chromosome number, we didn't need the scaffold. So after deleting the unwanted scaffold, we only have the chromosome of each organism, but remember that we have here shortened the chromosome name of that Solanum lacopersicum by deleting SL02, so we need to delete that SL02 in GFF file as well. Open the GFF file, and here also the Solanum lacopersicum chromosome name have with that SL2.50, so we need to delete it also from here. So copy, then go to edit, replace, replace what, and replace with, only keep the cursor and replace, click on replace all, so we only have that chromosome name, and save it, and then go to the multiple Synteny plot, then we put all that file one by one again, gene link, and then start to check. So here we are, so we have these only chromosome of Gmax, oryza sativa, Arabidopsis thaliana, and the Solanum lacopersicum. So after putting all the files, click on start, so it shows that these our Solanum lacopersicum genes, HSP70 family genes, were linked with these sativa, Arabidopsis, or Gmax genes. So you can also change the color of these chromosome. So you can place the cursor, right click, then element editor, group element, and here is the fill color, so you can choose any other color, like I choose this red one, and select. So all our chromosome becomes red. So I want to change the name of GMAX color name. GMAX name color group. And here is the color. So I want red. Okay, so you can also drag it into any place where you want to keep. So in this way you can change the color of name or chromosome, whatever, according to your choice. And these red dot shows that these are the linked genes that were linked with the other in other crops. So then click on save graph and JPG and then save it into your destination place and then use it into your manuscript or your dissertation. So in this way you can prepare the Synteny or collinearity analysis of multiple species to study your family genes. So this is all about Synteny analysis. If you have any query, so please comment or contact me. I will try to solve it. Hopefully it will help you. Thank you.